Now what we have here is the glomerulus right here. This is the Bowman's capsule, and this makes up the renal corpuscle. Now what you have is the afferent artery coming in here. Now if you look at the size of the afferent artery, it's thicker than the efferent artery, which is a little thinner. So if you have a lot of fluid coming in and a small little place to go out, well, there's gonna be pressure that's gonna build up. And what's gonna happen is you're gonna get some of the nutrients, urea, some waste products that are gonna get pushed out of this tissue, and then it's gonna collect into the proximal convoluted tubule here. Okay, so that's how it works. Again, you get a lot of pressure coming in. This is your blood. But what we're going to do is we're going to have so much fluid coming in, but look how much is going out. It's small. So what we need to do is we need to push out all the big byproducts, waste, urea, all in here. And what's going to do is this is going to get filtered right in here. Now, right in here, what we have is called the juxtaglomerulus cells. And this is on the afferent artery. And what they do is they actually have baroreceptors. And what they do is sense the pressure. And if they sense that there's too much pressure, then they might release something called renin to regulate your blood pressure. So that's the object of these guys right here. Okay, again, this is your glomerulus. This is the Bowman's capsule, and fluid is going to get pushed out in here. You're gonna have salts, urea, water, of course, and then it's gonna get pushed into the proximal convoluted tubule. And along the way, it's going to get filtered more and more and eventually come out as urine.